I'm MSC UK Ambassador James Strawbridge, and today I've travelled to West Burrowfirth on the Shetland Islands to meet Francis Fraser, a sustainable crab fisherman, who's going to show me a bit of crab picking the Shetland way. Francis, let's talk a little bit about MSC-certified Shetland crab. What makes it sustainable?
We have a minimum land and size, 140 mil.
And that means that, I guess, you're only landing nice, meaty crab, which tastes great for me as a chef, that's fantastic. But how does that like benefit the environment?
Once they come that size, then they've had the chance to spawn at least one season.
How do you actually manage, like, is it all done on deck where you have to get out your ruler and measure every single crab you land? How's it actually work, the fishery?
Well, we just have a measuring stick that if you get to know the size and nearly start looking, but if one is just borderline, then you just take the measuring stick and check it.
Do you have a preference, brown or white meat?
We usually mix it.
Yeah, that's what I do as well. Yeah. I think like that's the best way. Yeah. I have to say, I think like for me, it's brown for flavour and then white for texture and sweetness. But when you put it together, you get the best dishes.
Yeah, that's the best.
Well, look, I'm looking at these. I've cooked them, put them in a pot, and now I want to talk about how you pick a crab. A lot of people at home don't realise that this is a much more affordable way of buying crab. How do you pick your crab? Show me the Shetland way, and then we'll have a look and see if I do it the same. They are absolutely beautiful, by the way. Yeah. I can't wait to have a look at these.
Well, usually I start off just by getting the claws off of them first.
And for people who haven't done this before, it's as easy as this. You're literally twisting off the claws and the legs, and then in there we've got all of the meat we'll come back to.
Yeah, you've got the meat.
And in there you've got the brown meat.
That's the brown meat.
So we're going to scoop that out. I'd like some of that to take with me to cook. And pretty much everything in this part is completely edible, but there is one bit that you need to be careful of when you're actually cooking and eating crab.
That's what they call this, dead man's fingers.
Dead man's fingers.
Yeah, you can't eat them.
The clue's in the name, isn't it?
Yeah.
So avoid those. But other than that, there's nothing to be afraid of. A lot of people think, oh, this is going to be a stressful, hard work.
Yeah, that's it. If it's soft, you can eat it.
Yeah, if it's soft, you can eat it. I like that. That's great advice. Yeah. So next stage, what are we on to now? What would you do?
Well, I'll just take this leg off and then you can pick up the...
Can I just show these guys? Look at this. That's where you've got loads of beautiful white meat hiding almost in the knuckles, isn't
it? That's what it is,
How do you crack a claw?
Well...
It sounds like there's a joke in there somewhere, but...
I usually have a hammer. They do it with it. I just stand and see what...
So you're not hitting it really hard. This is a key thing. Don't whack it. If you whack it, you'll end up with shell right in the meat there, won't you?
Yeah, that's it, That's that.
Beautiful. Look at that. Super easy to do at home. Get involved, all hands on deck. Let's eat more of this MSC sustainable, certified Shetland crab.